People, welcome to this video. Let's see how to apply materials on 3D objects and how to render your project. Please leave us feedback to improve our videos in the future. In the previous videos, we have seen the etch command used to add filling and patterns on 2D objects, laying on the ground plane or any plane parallel to it. Whereas, if you need to fill 3D objects with their volume, you need to use other tools. Any 3D object is composed by two main parts: the wireframes, such as the sides and the vertices, that you can check by using the wireframe or the 2D wireframe view, and the 3D faces that compose the solid. Both wireframes and faces can be colored as you like by using the Properties section under the Home tab. If you select the whole 3D object, you will change the color for the overall solid, so both wireframes and faces. If you want to color just its edges, go to Color Edges inside the Solid Editing section under the 3D Tools tab. Select the edges interested, apply with the Enter key, and then pick the right color. Choose under Index Color to choose standard colors, or go to True Color to pick the color you like most. Make sure to use a wireframe view to check the side's color. If you want to color faces, go to Color Faces instead. Select the faces and choose the right color. Use a 3D point of view to check the faces. Each time you use the Color Edges or the Color Faces tool, you will apply a single uniform color. To apply multiple colors on the object edges or faces, you have to use the tools more than once. In professional projects, 3D objects are usually filled with the materials, able to render grass, glass, bricks, and other materials for a more professional and realistic preview. All materials are inside the Visualize tab, usually hidden by default. To show it, just right-click on a vacant space on top, go to Show tabs, and then to Visualize. Inside this tab, there is a section called Materials. The first button opens the materials browser used to import and check all the materials related to your project. Before adding any material on your objects, you have to import them into your overall project first. By default, your project has a unique material available called Global, as you can see from the list of the imported materials inside the Materials browser. Below, you have the whole list of the materials available from the Autodesk Library folder. If you want to import other materials on your project, just drag and drop them on the list above. Once the materials are imported, just select the interested object and click once on the material you want to apply to it from the Materials browser. Remember to use a 3D view that shows objects' volume, or you won't see any material on them. This material will cover any color applied with the Color Faces tool. Nothing will be applied on the wireframes. They will stay colored according to the Color Edges tool. You can also apply materials face by face. Hold Ctrl down to select faces singularly and then choose the material from the list. Each of these materials can be edited by double-clicking on them. The materials editor appears in order to change color, pattern, and other properties related to the selected material. Often check the sample above that you can change through its down arrow. When you finish, just close the editor. All the changes will be saved. To rename or remove a material from the list, just right-click on it. Let's see how to render your project This is useful to change your project in progress in detail. To check a good preview of your project, you can use the realistic view. However, this does not include all the details, especially when checking materials and shadows. For this reason, you need to render your project. To do so, click on the T button under the Visualize tab. This opens the render window that shows you a preview of your project rendered. Depending on the chosen quality, you will have to wait some time to see the render completed. Check the render progress bar to know its status. The render will be done on the whole workspace on the point of view chosen and fixed when you click on the render button. The render done will be shown completely on the render window open. You can zoom in and out by using your mouse wheel. Below, if you click on the down arrow on the left, you can check the history of all the renderings done in a chronological order from the most recent one. You can click on one to select and check it again, and eventually save or print it by clicking on the buttons above. Under the render section, you can also decide the render quality. The higher the quality is, the better the render will be, but the longer the time you have to wait to see it finished. Right below the render button, you can also set the render resolution in pixels. For more advanced settings, click on the arrow on the right to show the render presets manager. There are other ways to render your project. The default one is the window one, just seen, which sends the render to a new window in order to save and print it if you need. But through the second bar next to the render button, you can also render as viewport or region. If you choose viewport, you will directly render on your workspace your whole project. If you choose region, you will render just a selected part on your workspace by fixing two points on it. Remember that you will lose the render as soon as you change the point of view of your workspace, if you choose the viewport or the region render. For this reason, you need the window rendering to save it. To make your render more realistic, you can add any light, sky or environment. To add the sunlight, just go to Sun and Location and click on Sun Status. Accept the recommended settings and the Render Environment and Exposure panel appears. Here, you can turn on the environment light and adjust the exposure and the white balance values. To see the true effect of the sunlight, just render a region to see the difference. The effect of the sunlight can be edited through the image-based lighting section or the settings inside Sun and Location, adjusting the sun direction by choosing the date and the hour. Besides the sunlight, you can also add the secondary light sources, all listed under the lights section. The point light adds light coming from a fixed point and spreads in any direction. To fix it, just click on your workspace. This is shown with an orange sphere and can be moved just like a 3D object through its own gizmo. You can also regulate its light by selecting it and using the options inside the lights section. If you choose spot, you can add a directed light on your workspace, just like a torch. Fix an anchor point and then fix its target by fixing a second point. Apart from adjusting the light quality from the lights section, you can also adjust the spotlight as you like. If you select it, you can adjust its target by clicking and dragging the square in the center. Adjust its radius through the external blue arrows or adjust the external feather through the inner blue arrows. You can also move the spotlight by using its gizmo system. but this won't stop following its target and will change direction according to it. There are other light sources, like distant and web light. Check them out when you get practice. Let's see how to add environment and sky. To add horizon, turn off environment from the SUBTITLES panel and choose the perspective view by clicking on the button in the bottom right corner of the 3D view cube. At this point, you can add the sky through sun and location. If you want to add anything regarding the ground, like pavements, grass, and so on, you have to add them by using mesh objects or 3D solids. Let's see how to add shadows. Under the lights section, you can add two kinds of shadows. Choose ground shadows to add all shadows related to the basic sunlight. If you choose full shadows, you will apply both shadow caused by sunlight and by artificial secondary light sources. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel to discover more about Autodesk AutoCAD 2017.